It's an honor to be here in Kiev to demonstrate IFC's continued support for Ukraine, for its economy, and for its people. This is my first visit to Ukraine as IFC's regional director for Europe. Since Russia's invasion of Ukraine, we have been working closely with our clients to help them maintain operations and bringing in essential goods and services into the country. But this is the first time I am seeing for myself the impact of all of this. As I stand here at the very heart of Kiev, I feel firsthand what the Ukrainian people have been going through. With the air raid sirens, seeking shelter, and wishing for all of this to come to an end soon. This is a destroyed building in Irpin, which shows the extent of the damage. For now, the total cost of reconstruction and recovery is estimated at about 411 billion. So to help with that, we are moving forward across a whole range of sectors, including energy security, housing, and agriculture, as well as infrastructure. These houses have been reconstructed with IFC's help in partnership with the European Union. This program targets houses in affected regions across Ukraine. Private sector is the key to support Ukraine's reconstruction and economic activity, and IFC is doing this with our $2 billion support program for Ukraine. Today, I'm happy to note IFC has become the largest investor in a leading private equity firm, Horizon Capital, which is focused on supporting the tech industry. Our goal in partnering with Horizon Capital is to support this tech industry, which is vital for the economy, which is keeping jobs alive and generating income and employment.
Today is such a historic day. It's a day that I've dreamt about since October 2021, when we started this journey. And here we are celebrating 254 million, exceeding our target. We have a huge investor delegation who've come from all across the world. We're here in Kiev during a war, talking about Ukraine being open for business, talking about investing in the country, and our friends at IFC, we can mobilize even more capital.
So here in Ukraine, we see the economy that's functioning, but it needs support. So our message is clear. We will stand with the people of Ukraine every step of the way.